Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Kayleen if you're new here, and today we're going to be talking about calypso leaps. This isn't going to be a tutorial necessarily. I'm just going to go through the process of doing a calypso. I'm going to give you some little tips and pointers on how to make them look good, how to fix the little problems that a lot of you have been messaging me about. Okay, so we're gonna start from the very beginning, the chenets. So you can either do a high chenet, low chenet, or just the low chenet. When I did calypsos for the first time, I like to do a high chenet and a low chenet, just because it gives me a little bit more energy and I feel like I have more momentum to get myself up in the air. So one thing that might be holding you back if you're having trouble getting off of the floor is that you might be prepping and doing your chenets with your body a little bit back, like you're hesitating, you're not going like forward into it. Rather, you're kind of like holding back and your body is coming back this way. Okay, so you really need to wash your upper body and make sure everything stays in line. You have your nice port de bras. You need to act like you're going to something rather than like holding back, staying in place, and then all of a sudden popping up. I think it helps a lot to just have more energy and make sure you're going forward. You also need to make sure that you're going in a straight line when you do your chenets. As I've been watching the audition clips and the videos that you guys send me, I see a lot of you that end up doing kind of like a chenet to one of the corners instead. So rather than spotting something directly side and going straight side, because that's where your leg is going to extend to, you guys are doing like a little like this way, and then you're trying to come out. And it just doesn't make sense. Your body's going all over the place. Keep your chenets in one line and make sure that you spot. I know this isn't a turn, but it's a turning jump. So you still need to spot as you do the chenets, and then you pop up to the front. Your upper body should be to the front. So the next piece of the puzzle, your front leg. I learned how to do a calypso by doing high chenet, low chenet, and then just a fan. Because that's essentially what you're doing is in the air, you fan this front leg out to 90 degrees. So one exercise that you could do if you're having trouble just with that action is just to do across the floor, high chenet, low chenet, fan, and I'll show you that. So you'll go high, low, and a fan. Okay, I had to put tennis shoes on because it's slippery and I don't wanna fall. So you'll just go high chenet, low chenet, and then stop to the front, fan around. And then you can just do like a three-step turn out of it and keep going and practicing that. I know that in some versions of calypsos, you release back or maybe you push back with your arms. I would focus on just getting straight to the front first before you try and do any crazy releases. Okay, so that's your front leg. For your back leg, which is the problem that I think most of you have based on my comments and my DMs, a lot of you have trouble keeping your knee in line with your toe. You're dropping it, right? So this is what you look like in the air. You have your front leg extended, back leg is an attitude. And essentially all this is it's my split, and then I bend into the back attitude. If this is hard for you, if you can't get it on the floor, that means you're probably not flexible enough right now to actually do it in the air. So really, really make sure you're stretching, make sure you work on this position. But this back leg, it's not just about flexibility. Keeping that knee in line with your toe is actually a lot of muscle strength in your back and in your glutes. So to be quite honest, when you guys first told me that you needed help with calypsos, I was like, I don't really wanna do this video because I feel like they're pretty easy. Like, I don't really have an issue with them, but I realized it's because I grew up doing a lot of ballet, and in a lot of ballet, you practice the attitude position. You have to be able to hold that in a lot of different ballet moves. Even if you're just like going from a passe into an arabesque, you go through this position. So I was already naturally trained to have a good attitude, and so once I just added that into the fan, it was fine, it was easy. But a lot of you might not have had that training, and I realize that now, and so I wanna give you a few exercises that you can do that will keep your knee in line with your toe. So I showed this in my little technique class that I did a while ago, which I'll link below if you wanna do that. But it's a really good way to train the correct muscles, which are basically like your glute muscles in your back, and it'll train the shape of your attitude to be how you want it in your calypso. So you'll go into a coupe, and it's really important that you start in coupe, and you're thinking about squeezing these muscles, rotating, using your turnout, and that's gonna come from these muscles right here. You're gonna squeeze as hard as you can, and you're thinking about this knee pushing back. This foot, this heel, is connected to my back ankle. Now from here, the exercise I would recommend is just to go from a coupe to an attitude and then back down. And the important thing, like I said, is to maintain that shape. Maybe do 10 of them where you just go coupe, attitude, coupe, attitude. And I'm gonna say what I always say, which is either have a mirror or record yourself and watch it back after and make sure that you're maintaining the right shape. If you're really having trouble engaging this muscle, then look online for some other turnout exercises because you might need to work on your turnout first and foremost. Also, after you do all those pulses, so maybe you do 3 sets of 10 of these, so coupe and up, coupe and up 10 times, and then on the 10th one, hold it and just try and hold it maybe for a couple of 8 counts and you'll really, really start to feel it and you'll notice what the back of your leg is doing as well. So another thing that might be helpful for those of you who are struggling to get height in your leap is to actually practice this jump with 2 bent legs. I mentioned doing this when I talked about turning centers. I have a video about that as well, and that'll be linked below. I think some people call it a barrel leap or just like a double stag. That can like take a little bit of the technique out of your head and just help you figure out how to get your energy up in the air, get your hips up. So you would basically do the same thing as a calypso. You would go high chené, low chené, but then from here, you just do 2 bent legs. I think that that can help to really figure out how to get your hips up in the air. Remember that calypsos are just another leap, and the principles are gonna be the same as something like a sauté or a grand jeté. And I actually made a whole other video talking about leaps and tips and tricks for those. So if you wanna click right here, I'll post that. And then on this side, I'll put a playlist with all of my technique videos. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe and click the little notification bell if you want to be notified. I post new videos every single week. Give it a thumbs up if you liked it. Okay, bye.
That was horrible.
This is how I just want to record. I'm like, never mind, I don't like